Hello everyone, in today's video I am going to talk about 20 JavaScript interview questions. My name is Talha and this channel is all about showing you how to become a highly paid IT pro really fast. Let's get started. Question number one, is JavaScript case sensitive? Yes, JavaScript is case sensitive, which means that we have to follow the naming conventions and declaration rules while declaring or using them. For example, if in the JavaScript code we have an object with the name of employee, in the object of employee, let's say we have age, we have name. So now whenever we want to use the age or name of the employee, we have to use it with the same spelling and capitalization of words as we have declared them previously. So here you can see that it's perfect. So now let's try to change the name and let's try to make it capitalize. So when we capitalize it and when we run it, here you can see that we have an error, which means that yes, JavaScript is case sensitive. Question number two, what is the difference between Java and JavaScript? When we talk about Java, it is a complete programming language just like any other programming language. For example, C or C++. Java is an object-oriented programming language, while JavaScript is a scripted language. Java gets compiled first and then runs the code, while JavaScript is a scripting language and it gets executed line by line instead of getting executed by the compiler for entire code. Question number three, what are JavaScript cookies? Cookies are small files containing user information. Cookies are created when a user visits the website and are stored on the user's computer. In cookies, we have the information of the user like his personal information, shopping cart information, or his browsing routines, etc. Question number four. What is the difference between local and session storage? Let's talk about session storage first. In session storage, the stored data gets lost whenever the page session is closed, and the stored data is sent back to the server for every request. If we talk about local storage, however, in local storage, we do not have the concept of client and server. In this storage, we do not send the data back to the server for every request because it has no expiration time like in session storage. The data in this storage will stay until cleared manually. Question number five. How DOM are used in JavaScript? DOM stands for Document Object Model. It is responsible for how different objects presented in the documents will interact with each other. DOM is needed to develop pages. It includes objects like links, paragraphs, etc. We can use these objects to include actions such as deletion or addition of something. DOM is also needed to add extra capabilities to a web page. Using it with an API gives it an advantage over other available models. Question number six. What is the difference between the push and pop method in JavaScript? Push method, if we talk about it, in JavaScript, we use the push method to add or append the elements to the end of the array. Using this method, we can add multiple elements by using multiple arguments. So if we talk about the example of the push method in JavaScript, then let's say if we have an object of cars, so in which we have Toyota, Honda, and Suzuki. So if we want to add BMW or append it at the end of the array, we just have to write the array name, which is essentially cars, and then we need to write here dot push, and inside the double quotes, We are going to write here the car name that we want to add. Now the cars will have Toyota, Honda, Suzuki, and BMW added in the array. Let's talk about pop method. The pop method is exactly the opposite of the push method. When a pop method is used, it removes the last element from the array and returns it to its caller. For example, if we have an object cars, and it has Toyota, Honda, Suzuki. If we write here cars.pop, I go here and I change it to pop, what would happen that it would eliminate the last member from the array. So here you can see the last member that we have is Suzuki. So if we call this pop method here, it would eliminate the Suzuki from the array, and only Toyota and Honda will remain. Question number 7. What are timers in JavaScript? In JavaScript, the timers are used to execute the piece of code at a set time, or if we want to repeat a particular code at a certain interval of time. For that purpose, we have some built-in functions like setInterval, set timeout, and clear interval. The set interval function and delay is used to execute the given function repeatedly and only halts when it gets cancelled. Set interval takes two arguments, one is function and the other one is delay. In the similar way, the set timeout function is used to start a timer that calls the particular function after a mentioned delay. It also takes two arguments, function and delay. The clean interval, it takes the ID as the argument and it is used for the timer to stop. Question number 8. What will be the result of this 4 plus 5 plus a string 9? Well, as we can see that 4 and 5 are integers, so they will be added together and will result in 9. Now, the last numeric 9 is in the inverted commas, so it is considered as a string, not a numeric number. So what the program will do, it will concatenate the addition of 4 and 5 with this 9. And the answer that we will get would be 99 and not 18. Question number 9. What is the scope of variables in JavaScript? In JavaScript, a variable can have two types of scope, global and local scope. If we talk about the local scope, in local scope, the defined variable will only be available and visible within the function it was defined. For example, the parameters of the function are local to its function. So here you can see that we have a function and we have a variable car name inside of this function. So it means that I cannot access this variable outside of this function, which makes it pretty local. I can only access this variable and use it in the premises of this function and not outside of it. So if we talk about the global scope, it means that the defined variable will be available anywhere in the JavaScript code. So here, if I define the car name right outside the function, then I can use this car name inside the myCar function, and I can also use it outside everywhere. Question number 10. What is this keyword? This refers to the object it belongs to. In the case of functions, this refers to its owner object. In our case, the owner object is the global object. Question number 11. How many types of functions are there in JavaScript? There are three types of functions in JavaScript. One is immediately invoked function expression. The second is the named function. And the third one is the anonymous function. If we talk about the immediately invoked function, these type of functions run when the browser encounters them. The benefit of using these functions is that they run immediately when a browser will get them and produces the direct output. Immediate invoked functions, they look something like this. If we talk about the named functions, these are just simple functions to which we define in the code, and then we call them wherever and whenever we need them. They are useful when we need a function that is needed over and over and over again in the program. The named function would look something like this that you see on your screen. We can call this function over and over again in our program. Let's talk about anonymous function. These functions do not have names, and that's why they are known as anonymous functions. They are tied with an event or variable or something else to run. Let's have the same function as above, but this time without providing any name. So here you can see on our screen, this is an anonymous function. Question number 12. What is the difference between not defined and undefined? Undefined is a situation when we have declared a variable, but we have not initialized or given any value to it. For example, if we have a variable x here, now we will get a message saying that x is undefined, means we have not given the value or assigned any value to the x. If we talk about the not defined, in case of not defined, we do not declare the variable and try to use it in the program. For example, if I use it like console.log, and if I call y inside of it, if I use it, now the compiler will give the message that y is not defined. And it is true because we have not defined y in the code anywhere. Question number 13. In how many ways we can pass object or primitive types in JavaScript? Well, one thing should be clear here that the object gets passed by the reference and the primitive types get passed by the value. So let's talk about the call by reference. If we call about by reference, in this concept, we do not call the object by its real name, but we call it by some other reference. In the call by reference, it copies the address of the object, and this address gets used to access it wherever it is needed. If we talk about accessing it by value, while in the call by value, we make the copies of the argument and use that copy wherever is needed. The benefit of making copies is that whenever a change is made in the copy, it does not affect the original argument. Question number 14. What are deferred scripts in JavaScript? During the page loading, the parsing of HTML code gets paused until the script has not stopped working by default. It means that if the server is slow or our script is heavy, then the web page will be displayed with a delay. But if we use a deferred script, it reduces the loading time and ultimately the web pages will be displayed faster. Question number 15. What will be the output of the following code when executed? The first answer will be true and the second one will be false. The reason behind that is that in JavaScript, you have two types of equality operators. The triple equal operator and the double equal operator. The double equal operator just compares the values and then returns the result, while the triple equal operator will behave just like an equality operator, but it additionally checks the data type as well. It will result in false if the expression on both sides has the same value but different data types. Question number 16. What will be the output of the following lines of code? The answer to this code for the first line is 0.20000, so on and so forth until 4. And for the second line of code, it will be false. The explanation for this answer is that the sum of two numbers, 0.1 plus 0.1, that is essentially 0.200004, like, you know, you have multiple zeros and then 4, and it is not exactly equal to 0.2. That is why when comparing them in the second line of code, it will return false because both the expression around the operator were not equal. Question number 17. What will be the order of output from the following code and why? In this example, 2 should be displayed after 1 since the delay is 0 milliseconds in the setTimeout function. But this does not happen as we thought. You can see that 1 and 3 are displayed first as they are logged by the simple calls using the console.log without using any delay parameter. 2 is displayed after 3 because the browser has an event loop that will check the event queue and then processes the pending event. So the same thing will happen with 2 as it will be added to the event queue and then the next line of the code will be executed first, and that's why 2 will get printed at the end. Question number 18. We have 2 functions below. You could see them on your screen. Will they both return the same thing? If yes, then why? To your surprise, these 2 functions will not return the same thing. Rather, one function that you have will return hi, but the function 2 will be undefined. Although semicolons are optional in JavaScript, however, the line containing return statement in function 2, a semicolon will be added automatically, which will result at the end of the line, and that is why it is set undefined as the output. Question number 19. What would be the output of the code that you see on your screen? So the output would be something like this. You can see on your screen, this would be the output of this code. 2 plus the string 2 plus string 2 will give us 222 because the second string 2 is a string and JavaScript will just concatenate the string with the integer. The same will happen with the last 2, which is also a string. So JavaScript will concatenate the last one as well, and it shows the output 222. In the second example, we have 42 as the output. Based on the order of operations, the first operation which is to be performed is plus and then the string 2, and it will be treated as a unary operator. So JavaScript will convert this string 2 into the 2 of integer type, and it will add these 2 2s together and it will answer in 4. In the end, we have another 2 which is a type of string. So what JavaScript will do here, JavaScript will concatenate it with 4 and it results in 42. In the final line of code, we have A and B as a string, and we cannot apply the minus operator on A and B. So it will result in NaN, which says not a number, or which stands for not a number. And then this NaN gets concatenated with 2, which is at the end. So here you can see that when I have run these 3 lines, I have the output exactly as I've told you right here. Question number 20. What will be the output of the following piece of code that you see on your screen? In JavaScript, both and OR operator returns the first determined logical value, and it is usually evaluated from left to right. So in the first case, the output will be this that you see on your screen. As the first part of the code is a string that will be printed as it is, and from the OR operator, 1 will be printed because 0 and R1 evaluates to 1. And in the second line of code, we will be having the first part printed as it is. And from the second part of the code, where we have AND operator, it will give us the answer of 2. So the final answer will be 1 and operator of 2 equals 2. This is because in AND operations, the left side will be evaluated first, and it is interpreted as a Boolean value, and if it is false, then false gets returned and the right side of AND operation does not get evaluated because it never comes to it. Otherwise, if the left side is true, then the AND operator will evaluate the right side only. Because in the case of AND, both has to be correct. When the first one is false, there is no point in checking the second one. So if both the parameters are returned as true, then the AND operator will return the value of the parameter in JavaScript, and that is why it will give you the output as 2. So these were the 20 JavaScript interview questions. Hope you have liked this video. Thank you so much for watching, and do not forget to subscribe to our channel to get the latest videos to help you advance your IT career.